The hard problem that is closely related to the Diffie-Hellman security property is the discrete log problem. Discrete logs are like continuous logs, but over a discrete group. So continuous log, if we have a to the x equals b, and we know a and b, we can solve for x. That's the log base a of b. And there are well-known efficient ways to compute these logarithms. One of the earliest use of computers was to compute these tables of logarithms. With discrete numbers, this gets much more interesting. So now we have a to the x equal b modulo some value n. And our goal is to solve for x, which is the discrete log base a of b. And this turns out to be, as far as everyone can tell, a very hard problem when n is a large prime number. It's not clear that the discrete log always exists, and for certain choices of a, b, and n, it would not exist. But if we choose n as a large prime number and a as a generator, well then by definition, it must exist. What it means for a number to be a generator is that if we raise g to each power, what we get is a permutation of the numbers in the group Zn. So as a little demonstration, certainly not a proof, here's a code that produces the permutation for given some generator and some modulus, raises the generator to every power between 1 and the modulus minus 1. So we can try that with a fairly small prime number. So you can see the results. We'll use 277 as our prime number and 5 as a generator for 277. One could check that in a brute force way, just show that it all produces all the numbers. And we'll see that in the output for generator permutation. These are the results. And you can see the first one is 5. That's 5 to the 1. 25 is 5 to the 2. 125 is 5 to the 3. The next one is 71, because 5 to the 4 mod 277 is 71. And if we look at all the numbers here, it would be a permutation on the numbers from 1 to 276. Other than the early ones, it would be fairly hard to predict where a number is in this sequence. You could certainly compute the whole sequence to find it. The question the discrete log is asking is, given a number, can you figure out where it would be in this sequence? Or can you figure out the power that you need to raise the generator to find it? And the claim is that that's hard to do. Showing the sequence certainly is not enough to convince you that that's hard to do. And there's no proof that it's hard. The reason people believe it's hard is that many smart people have tried to find good ways of doing this, and none of the solutions run in polynomial time, that the fastest known solutions are exponential. That means essentially that the only way to solve this is to try all possible powers until you find the one that works. You can do a little better than that by trying powers in a clever way, and you can exclude some of the powers more quickly, but you can't do any better than doing this exponential search, which is exponential in the size of n. So this is something we have to be careful about when we talk about hard problems. When we say it's exponential, well, it's not exponential in the value of n. It's linear in the value of n. We just need to try n operations. But the magnitude of n grows as 2 to the number of bits needed to write down n. So as long as that's the best solution to discrete log, then for very large n, it's intractable. No matter how many computing resources you have, you can't do this exponential search. You can't find the value of x that's the discrete log of b base a mod n. So as long as no one can find a fast way to solve the discrete log problem, as long as n is large and is an arbitrary instance of this problem, we think that it should be hard to compute x given a and b and the modulus. So for this quiz, we'll assume that we have an adversary that's passive. So all they can do is eavesdrop on the messages. But they also have access to a powerful computing resource. They have a procedure dlog that is a fast procedure for computing discrete logs that works on any inputs. And they have modular exponentiation, a fast procedure that outputs base to the power mod modulus. And now the question is, can they break a Diffie-Hellman key? So we're assuming that they're a passive attacker. So they've eavesdropped on all the messages between Alice and Bob. So they have all these values that were sent over the secure channel. And the possible answers are no, that it's impossible with no more resources or information. Or that yes, there is a way to do it. And here's the way that she would compute that.